This is Josiah Plays Planescape Torment Enhanced Edition. Alright, we're going to finish up what we're doing here in the mortuary. There's no reason to mess with Iveen again. I'm gonna quick save, talk to these other zombies. One moment, you mean the time it takes for light to travel one plank length? Is that the official definition of a moment? Apparently there's nothing we can do with this one. Do I want to kill these? Kinda. Effine doesn't seem to care. I was a tad over. Well, maybe the light was just having an off day and traveling slowly this time. Maybe the light was like, you know what? Just because I can travel at the speed of light, just because I normally travel at the speed of light, maybe today I don't feel like it. Maybe today I want to hold down shift and go into walk mode. Maybe the light was role-playing for its immersion. And it traveled slower than usual. We don't know.
Sorry about knocking you over before. It was an accident.
And I'm also sorry about this. I probably shouldn't be killing these. You were just talking about the shortest measurable unit of time you can imagine. Ah, that does sound very short. Even though, I'm not gonna lie to you, I don't know what a plank length is. Not gonna lie. Don't know what it is.
Don't you get dizzy with your eyeballs facing like that?
Some of these might have loot, but maybe not. We're obviously not going to kill the one that's faking it. We're not going to kill any of the ones on the first floor. We might not kill any of the ones on the third floor, I'm not sure. Incoming ban, but I'm copy-pasting. Why would I ban you for that? There's no ban. Okay, here we go. We're about to learn some science. Are you ready? Science time! How long is a moment in time? At last, a question to which a precise answer can be given. In the Middle Ages, an hour was considered to be made of 40 minutes, with each minute divided into 40 moments. Disregarding the elastic notions of time then prevailing, and allowing 3,600 modern seconds to the hour, that gives us 90 seconds to each minute. Okay, so far I'm confused.
How did you become to be a librarian? All the other jobs taken?
There's blankly. Goodbye.
Damn.
No bots here. Yeah, I have no bots. And even if I did have a bot, I wouldn't set the time people out for posting long blocks of text. I'm the kind of person that likes to post long blocks of text myself. Nothing else I can do with this one. I thought one of these...
Damn.
I thought one of these there was something I could do with after having read all the documents and stuff that I've read. Dahl doesn't seem to give a shit. A plank length is the shortest measurable distance, the minimum wavelength of light. Okay, that does seem extremely short. Anonymous says, by the way, You do realize that light travels its maximum speed only in vacuum, right? Well, how fast does it travel in unvacuum? Still travels pretty fucking fast, even down here in the atmosphere, right? Okay, we're gonna kill this one.
What's up? Okay.
I don't believe in what's being done to these poor, tortured corpses. I will end this. Man, Mort is a bad motherfucker. He puts it down. It's all relative. Was that a pun or not? That shows how ignorant I am. You want to get me into ignorance zone, you start talking about science or math, and yeah, you will quickly find out that I know nothing. Talking about history, I know almost nothing. Talking about English, I know close to nothing.
Good is done. Huh? Sure, why not?
All right.
Depends on unvacuumness.
So, why are you walking in a triangle?
There's a true blank. Yeah, there's nothing else I can do with this one either. None of these are really dropping loot, which it doesn't surprise me, but... I was hoping for a little bit of loot. Some bandages, something. Kind of back to the first room. Nothing going on in here. Alright, let's go back. Oh, this one. XP's. Made you look it up. Apparently Berkeley guys slowed light down to 17 meters per second. It's still kind of fast, but obviously it's nowhere near as fast as the speed of light. So that's pretty slow. For light. For a person, it's really fast. But not so much for light.
Done.
Okay, so now if I start killing zombies up here where these dustmen are they gonna lose their shit? I think they will. And I don't want to kill dustmen, so... Now that I killed that one, are any dustmen like going crazy on me? Okay, what if I try to kill this one real quick, right in front of a dustman? Apparently the dustmen do not care. That seems like it's not how it should be. So nothing new with this one. These are some really unconcerned dust men. Practically wind level. You know, very cool. So how did they do that? How did they slow light down that much? Whatever I thought I was remembering about being able to do something else with one of these zombies, I must have been wrong. Hey, 65 XP a pop, you know what I'm saying? What are you still doing here? Killing zombies, obviously. I wonder what this does to your alignment, if anything. Pretty sure it's not an evil act to destroy an unliving, unmindless. They're basically just like an inanimate object, honestly. Well, I think we've killed all the zombies on this floor, and I don't think we're gonna kill any on the first floor for reasons. Find the journal, find Farad. Alright, back down to the first
floor. Done.
So, what we're gonna do next is save the game and then try to have a chat with this Sogo, and I'm not sure what's gonna happen as a result of that. I just remember that it's possible that it's bad. We might even get out of the mortuary this episode. Maybe. Maybe not. You see a tired-looking man in a black robe. His narrow face is extremely pale, and he doesn't look as if he has been sleeping. His shoulders are slumped, and the flesh sags loosely beneath his bloodshot eyes. He looks so lost in thought, he doesn't even notice you.
Greetings.
Updated my journal.
Greetings. The man turns to face you and makes a slight bow. You suddenly notice that his eyes aren't bloodshot so much as they have a red tinge to them.
I am Sogo. How may I?
He suddenly seems to notice your scars, and the corner of his mouth twitches.
I'm sorry, sir. Are you lost?
No, I'm not lost. I had some questions.
I did not recall admitting you.
Sogo looks at you suspiciously, and his eyes gleam red in the light of the torches.
May I ask what you're doing here?
Snap his neck!
To see someone.
Sogo nods.
Are you here to see? I would be more than happy to direct you.
A Don,
Does he still work here, or... Adan?
Sogo's eyes narrow, and the red tinge you saw in them before seems more pronounced.
None of that name resides within the mortuary halls, living or dead.
His mouth twitches, and to your surprise, he sniffs the air for a moment. Very nice, subtle little piece of, little clue, little foreshadowing. Something later.
Then I must have misspoke.
Corners of Sogo's mouth twitch again and his eyes gleam.
What is your business here?
Run for it! What could go wrong?
I'm here to see someone. I'm here to see Dahl.
Dahl. Dahl the Scrivener can be found in the receiving room on the upper floor.
Corner of Sogo's mouth twitches briefly.
He is rather busy, and his health is failing. Unless you have pressing business, I would not disturb him.
What's wrong with Dahl?
Oh, there is nothing wrong with him. Dahl is...
Sogo clicks his teeth.
Old. His long devotion to cataloging the dead has nearly run its course. Death will no doubt soon follow the wasting sickness he has contracted.
Very well, I will keep my visit with him brief. Farewell.
Sogo nods and his mouth twitches again. He doesn't even seem to be aware of it.
Return when you have paid your respects, and I will unlock the front gate for you. It is after 9 bells, so you'll have to leave as soon as you conclude your business.
Thank you. I will return.
So, yeah, I could get him to let me out right now and escape the mortuary. But there is one more very important, honestly, thematically and narratively, the most important thing in the entire mortuary. One thing left undone. Back, and I'm not figuring that slow light shit out just to look smart in your chat. Well, can't you just cut and copy some paste some shit? I mean... Oh, the music starts. Dianara's theme. Here we go. A ghostly woman appears. This looks like a large tomb. The marble surface gives it a rather elegant look. The plaque on this bier says, it actually reads, "Here lies Dianara." And you may remember seeing her from the intro little movie. She was in it at the very end. Dianara. All right, let's talk to her.
You see a strikingly beautiful, ghostly form before you. Her arms are crossed and her eyes are closed. She has long, flowing hair, and her gown seems stirred by some ethereal breeze. As you watch, she stirs slightly, and her eyes flicker. Let's wait.
You! What is it that brings you here? Have you come to see firsthand the misery you have wrought? Perhaps in death I still hold some shred of use for you, my love.
And that is the incredible voice talent of Jennifer Hale, whom you may know from every other game that's ever been made. Her eyes slowly open, and she blinks in confusion for a moment, as if uncertain where she is. She looks around slowly, then sees you. Her tranquil face suddenly twists into a snarl. Voice drops to a hiss.
My love, do I know you?
The spirit makes a begging motion with her hands.
How can it be that the thieves of the mind continue to steal my name from your memory? Do you not remember me, my love?
The ghost stretches out her arms.
Think.
Her voice becomes desperate again.
The name Dianara must evoke some memory within you.
think I feel the stirrings of memory. Tell me more. Perhaps your words shall chase the shadows from my mind, Dianara.
Oh, at last the fates show mercy. Even death cannot chase me from your mind, my love. Do you not see? Your memories shall return. Tell me how I can help you, and I shall.
Know who I am.
You are one both blessed and cursed, my love. And you are one who is never far from my thoughts and heart.
Blessed and cursed? What do you mean?
The nature of your curse should be apparent, my love. Look at you. He points at you. Death rejects you. Your memories have abandoned you. Do you not pause and wonder why?
1 second. I'll be right back. Okay, sorry. I had to look outside for a second. Do I not pause and wonder why? Yes, I pause and wonder why a bunch.
Memories aside, and assuming death has rejected me, why is that a curse?
I do not doubt your ability to rise from the dead. I do believe that every incarnation weakens your thoughts and memories. You claim you have lost your memory. Perhaps it is a side effect of countless deaths? If so, what more will you lose in successive deaths? If you lose your mind, you will not even know enough to realize that you cannot die. You shall truly be doomed.
Countless deaths? How long has this been going on?
I do not truly know, except that it has gone on long enough.
Animus has basically dispersed the light, make it go all kinds of sideways through cleverly constructed synthetic material with magnetic fields. Without specifics, one might as well say magic. Alright, good to know. So it's just Numenera shit.
I had some other questions.
What is it you wish to know?
Who are you?
Oh yeah, we've been through this.
Blessed and cursed. I'm still trying to get my bearings, actually. What else can you tell me about myself?
I know that you once claimed you loved me, and that you would love me until death claimed us both. I believed that, never knowing the truth of who you were, what you were.
What am I?
I cannot.
He suddenly freezes, and she speaks slowly. Carefully, as if her voice frightens her.
The truth is this. You are one who dies many deaths. These deaths have given the knowing of all things mortal, and in your hand lies the spark of life and death.
I die many deaths. Sounds pretty serious.
Those that die near you carry a trace of themselves that you can bring forth.
Well, I can't actually impersonate Jennifer Hale. The problem is when she does a voice, or when any female voice actor does a voice like Dianara's, which is basically just a normal female voice, there's no particular accent or like weird tonality or cadence or anything. I can't really reproduce that because I can't make my voice sound like just a female voice. So it's basically just a normal voice, but I'm trying to still make it sound more female than my normal voice, which, you know, if the voice had an accent or some strangeness to it that I could specifically emulate that, I could make it sound a little bit more like I think I'll be able to do a more convincing Fall from Grace than I can a convincing Dianara, even though they're played by the same voice actress. As Dianara speaks the words, a crawling sensation wells up in the back of your skull.
You suddenly feel compelled to look at your hand. As you lift it up and look at it, you can see the blood coursing sluggishly through your arm, pouring into your muscles, and in turn giving strength to your bones.
Oh.
Updated my journal.
And you know Dianara is right. You suddenly remember how to coax the dimmest spark of life from a body and bring it forth. The thought both horrifies you and intrigues you. You have remembered how to raise others from the dead, just casually, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes you just remember something like, oh yeah, I was gonna buy peanut butter at the store. And sometimes you casually remember how to raise the dead. To access this ability, select the Special Abilities button in the Quick Menu. You can only use this on party members that have died in your presence. It will not work on anyone who does not travel with you, and it will not work on party members you remove from the party while they are dead.
I had other questions.
What is it you wish to know?
I'm gonna try some other options based on the same thing I've already asked. Who are you?
Yes. Yes, the name does sound familiar.
Actually, no, hold on. I'll come back to that. Who I am, blessed and cursed. I had some other questions.
Can you tell me where I am?
Where are you? Why, you are here with me, my love. As in the times when life was something both of us shared. Now it is the eternal boundary that separates us.
He taught you CPR? Yeah, basically.
Eternal boundary?
Yanara sounds saddened.
It is a barrier I feel you shall never cross, my love. It is the barrier between your life and what remains of mine.
See. Perhaps you could answer some other questions.
What is it you wish to know?
I need to escape this place. Can you help me?
As you are about to ask Dianara the question, it catches in your throat. It occurs to you that if you tell her you are looking for an escape route, she may feel you are abandoning her. If you're going to ask her how to leave, you'll need to be delicate about it. Okay, we'll come back to this. I want to go back to who are you and say number two and see what happens.
Yes, yes, the name does sound familiar.
Yes? She seems hopeful. What memories does my name evoke?
None, I lied. What a dick move. Also, not very skillful manipulation.
Your name evokes passionate thoughts, though their content is unclear. Perhaps if you were to tell me more...
Oh, at last the fates show mercy. Even death cannot chase me from your mind, my love. Do you not see? Your memories shall return. Tell me how I can help you, and I shall.
We're back to here again. Okay, so this is the only option left.
Dianara, I am in danger. Can you guide me to a place of safety? I shall return as soon as I can to speak to you again.
In danger?
Dianara looks concerned.
Of course, my love. I will aid you any way I can.
She closes her eyes for a moment, and you watch an ethereal zephyr pass through her body, stirring her hair. I really wish her theme song looped during this conversation, but unfortunately it doesn't, and it really should, but... I always remember talking to her and hearing that music throughout. And yet now, it just plays one time, and then you're sitting here talking to her in it. Of course, in fairness, whenever I played this before, I wasn't reading shit out loud and stopping to comment and talk about it. I was just reading it silently to myself. So you could go through the conversation much faster then, and you probably wouldn't run out of the song, because you'd just be reading through it on your own, which is much, much faster. After a moment, the zephyr dies and her eyes slowly open.
Perhaps there is a way.
Yes?
I sense that this place holds many doors shrouded from mortal eyes. Perhaps you could use one of these portals as a means of escape.
Portals?
Portals are holes in existence, leading to destinations in the inner and outer planes. If you could find the proper key, you could escape through one of them.
Yanara pauses for a moment, as if attempting to remember.
Portals will reveal themselves when you have the proper key. Unfortunately, these keys can be almost anything. An emotion, a piece of wood, a dagger of silvered glass, a scrap of cloth, a tune you hum to yourself. I fear that the Dustmen are the only ones who would know the keys you could use to leave their halls, my love.
See. I had some other questions.
What is it you wish to know?
Nothing now, Dianara, though I shall return. Farewell.
Hold a moment. I learned much when I traveled with you, my love, and what you have lost, I have retained. I have not divulged all that I know to you. My sight is clear, whilst you fumble in the darkness for a spark of thought.
Too bad, shut up.
What is it your sight sees that I do not?
Time itself relaxes its hold as the chill of oblivion slowly claims us, my love. Glimpses of things yet to come swarm across my vision. I see you, my love. I see you as you are now, and...
Yanara grows quiet. Has your ranting tired you? You can be such a dick. Wonder if you can leave Mort with the key next to the portal and talk to her with it shining right next to her tomb. Maybe. But I don't think the game would have reactivity to that.
What is it? What do you see?
I see what lies ahead for you. It ripples through the plains, stemming outward from this point. Shall I speak of what I see?
Basically about to tell us the whole plot of the game.
Tell me.
First, I require a promise. Promise you will return, that you will find some means to save me or join me.
So here you've got some interesting... Things like this actually matter in the game, in terms of your alignment and stuff like that. Like, you can say, a lot of times in the game, it'll give you two dialogue options which are identical, and one will say truth and one will say lie. And what you're doing is you're telling the game what your character actually thinks, allowing you to lie about things and yet still trick the NPC that you're talking to into believing you mean the other thing. But making vows is like, you're saying your character is legitimately vowing this. And, like, you're kind of... If you break that vow, then it has a much larger impact on your alignment and possibly other interactions with other chats and stuff. So...
Promise that you will find some means to save me or join me.
Find it hard to believe that a woman I once loved would blackmail promises with me, from me. The price of such a promise is too high. I can straight up lie. Oh, it makes no such promise, Spectre. Or I can make the vow. I'm not gonna make the vow because I'm not trying to play a lawful character who makes vows and shit. But I feel like lying to her about something as important as this would also be a pretty huge dick move. So I gotta go with number 5, which is kind of the wishy-washy answer, but none of these other answers are really acceptable to me from the way I want to roleplay my character this time around.
I will do what I can.
Yanara stiffens. She looks as if she is about to say something, then sighs in defeat.
Very well, my love. As before, I shall have to place my trust in you.
Closes her eyes. She was not happy about that.
This is what my eyes see, my love. Unfettered by the shackles of time.
Prepare to continue.
You shall meet enemies three, but none more dangerous than yourself in your full glory. They are shades of evil, of good, and of neutrality, given life and twisted by the laws of the plains.
I remember this speech and her talking and the voice acting so clearly when I think about this game, and I always remember it with DNR's theme playing in the background. Just shows, I didn't always play games at Josiah speed. I used to play games at normal person speed, maybe a little bit slower than normal person speed. But now, since I started streaming and basically I started being a weirdo. No, that's not true. I didn't start being a weirdo. I've been a weirdo, but... Alright. Enemies 3. Shades of evil, good, and neutrality, given life, twisted by the laws of the plane. Sounds cool.
You shall come to a prison built of regrets and sorrow, where the shadows themselves have gone mad. There you will be asked to make a terrible sacrifice, my love. For the matter to be laid to rest, you must destroy that which keeps you alive and be immortal no longer.
Be immortal no longer.
Destroy what keeps me alive?
I know that you must die while you still can. The circle must come to a close, my love. You were not meant for this life. You must find that which was taken from you and travel beyond, into the lands of the dead.
I feel like this conversation alone has more voice acting than the entire new Torment game.
Die while I still can.
Updated my journal.
I do not doubt your ability to rise from the dead. I do believe that every incarnation weakens your thoughts and memories. You claim you have lost your memory. Perhaps it is a side effect of countless deaths. If so, what more will you lose in successive deaths? If you lose your mind, you will not even know enough to realize that you cannot die. You shall truly be doomed.
Countless deaths? How long has this been going on?
Alright, we've already asked that, and she's already answered it.
Farewell, Deonora.
I shall wait for you in death's halls, my love.
Smiles, but there is only sadness in it. Closes her eyes, and with an ethereal whisper, she fades. You're back with me, Chief! You kind of drifted out on me there.
Oh, I'm fine. You know who that spirit was?
Eh? Spirit?
Spectre I was talking to. The woman.
You were rattling your bone box with some woman? Where? Mort looks around, excited. What did she look like?
Right on top of the beer. Didn't you see her?
No, you just kind of drifted out for a bit there. Just stood there, statue-like. I was a little worried you'd gone addled on me again.
No, I'm fine. I think. Let's move on.
Journal hella updated. Let me just check something really fast. Wonder if I can get... Will she give me that speech again? Oh, she's gone. Wait, no, she's back. But I want the music to trigger. Damn it, this is important for my nostalgia. I want to see if the music will come on and she will say that speech while the music is on. Because that's what my nostalgia remembers. Well, she comes back, but we seem to get DNR's theme to play again, which is fine. All right, so that's Dianara, a very important character to the game, to the story. Very tragic figure, and I always really liked Dianara. Felt really bad for her, because she has been caused to suffer so much by the Nameless One. Reload MB. Anima says, nope, I'll keep my immortality. Bye. Runs away to the Sword Coast and joins Drift and Elminster to be the ultimate Mary Sue trio. Right. That does sound like fun.
Met a dustman named Soko at the mortuary front gate. He looks tired, as if he hasn't slept in weeks. Judging from the eyes and pallor of his skin, it looks like he has caught some sort of illness. Don't know whether to be horrified or impressed. When I spoke to Dianara in the vaults of the mortuary, she told me that my deaths had given me some control over life and death. If I see a body, I can see the faint traces of life in it and coax it forth. For some reason, it will only work on people who travel with me, but only if they die in my presence. Why? Traveling me with, do they become linked to me somehow?
Seriously, who starts the main quest with "You must die"? These people. Day 1, hour 1.
Encountered the ghost of a woman named Dianara, who prophesied that I would meet 3 enemies, but no more dangerous than myself in my full glory. Their shades of evil, of good, and of neutrality given life and twisted by the laws of the plains. She said that I would come to a prison built of regrets and sorrow, where the shadows themselves have gone mad. Here I will be asked to make a terrible sacrifice. For the matter to be laid to rest, I must destroy that which keeps me alive and be immortal no longer.
Sounds legit. Dianara. There she is. Ghostly apparition, Dianara, claims she knows you, that you are her love. Whatever keeps her on the physical plane must be powerful indeed for her to stave off death so long. Dying does not seem to have improved her disposition. Poor Dio. All right. There's the Dianara theme. Hold on, let's try something.
My love, you have returned to me. Can it be that your memories have returned?
Once again, Dianara materializes. This time her face is filled with desperation and her arms are outstretched as if she is reaching for something. As she fades in, the desperation in her face changes to relief.
This is what my eyes see, my love. Unfettered by the shackles of time. You shall meet enemies 3, but none more dangerous than yourself in your full glory. They are shades of evil, of good, and of neutrality, given life and twisted by the laws of the plains. You shall come to a prison built of regrets and sorrow, where the shadows themselves have gone mad. There you will be asked to make a terrible sacrifice, my love. For the matter to be laid to rest, you must destroy that which keeps you alive and be immortal no longer. I know that you must die while you still can. The circle must come to a close, my love. You were not meant for this life. You must find that which was taken from you and travel beyond, into the lands of the dead.
All right, cool.
I shall wait for you in death's halls, my love.
We're good. All right. I don't suppose there's any reason to talk to Sogo again. I think it's actually time to get out of here. Also, I can ask him about Dianara. As you approach, Sogo sniffs the air when he looks up. When he sees you, he bows slightly.
Did you find what you were looking for?
Yes, and I'm heading for the gate now. Farewell.
I lied. I'm not heading for the gate. I'm heading away from the gate, sucka. Also, I destroyed all your skeletons, including your giant skeletons that must have been quite expensive to create. Let's go. Let's hit the portal and bounce. See, like, watch. Let's say I come down here, right? Let's say I come down here and I'm like, do-do-do-do-do, you know what I don't have? This. Now we go over here. See? No portal. You straight up don't get the portal unless you have that on you. I thought I remembered this song being so much longer. It really is a very short piece of music. Or maybe it did loop in the original game. There we go. Finally! Finally! 6 hours and 45 minutes into the playthrough, we are leaving the mortuary. Yes! We're finally leaving the mortuary in a very timely fashion. So it's time to save again. Here we go. Oh no, did you get stuck? Hey, Shaden Beamdog. Oh wait, are you actually from Beamdog? I bet you are, that's why it's in your name. No, I didn't get stuck. I'm just a crazy person that plays games extremely slowly. I didn't get stuck. And here come the shadows. Which look... You can definitely see the visual reference that they had for the Sorrow Fragments in the new Torment, based on those shadows. How's it going, Beamdog friend? So far, I gotta say I'm impressed. I like the Enhanced Edition. This is my favorite game of all time. I've played it many times, but now there's the Enhanced Edition, which I was really excited about, and it is really good. I like what you guys did with the UI a lot. I love the highlight all button here. Everything,
Chief,
all the UI elements look really good.
I won't fail you again, I swear.
That was kind of random, Mort. Everything looks really good. You know what I really like for some reason? I really like this. When you examine an item, just the way this is done is really nice. All right, we got some loot.
All right.
Here. Some copper commons and Penn's note. There's a whole lot of background work, but we really wanted to still feel like the original game. Yeah, that was really important to me, and I'm glad you guys didn't like alter the actual narrative or flow of the game. You just stuck to purely like interface and user friendliness type of. And, like, maybe correcting errors in the text or whatever, but, that's good. It's really good. Let's see what Penn's note has to say. This note has been written with remarkable penmanship upon the finest parchment. Alright, so it's written to Vaxus, and as we know, we just met Vaxus. He was the guy disguised as a zombie in the mortuary. So, this Penn person is obviously working with Vaxus. And he writes... If you are reading this, then you have undoubtedly failed in your task and have been forced to use the escape route I arranged. I told you that your little disguise idea was ridiculous. In any case, you'll need to lay low for a while. The Dustmen may be deluded, but they are not fools, and they will certainly seek retribution for our intrusion. I've left you some coins. Use them to secure a hiding place in the Hive, preferably in Ragpicker's Square. The Dustmen will be unwilling to look for you there. Once you have secured a new hiding place, I have a new mission for you. Find out where Farrod is getting those bodies he's delivering to the mortuary. It's apparently causing the Dustmen a great deal of upset, and I wouldn't mind knowing myself. Reports are that stone-faced Dustman at the Gathering Dust Bar, Initiate Emmerich, I think the fool's name is, has been sending out finders to try and mark Farrod's movements. See if you can find out how far along he is and hinder his efforts until we know more about Farrod's activities. Don't want Emmerich finding out something before we do. So it sounds like going and talking to Emmerich at the Gathering Dust Bar would be a good lead for maybe finding out more about Farad. Hold on to Penn's note. This is just a tiny little tomb. Called tomb, as you can see. I like this little dive right here. I like to be being able to zoom in and out is great. Super great. I think 12 is the number of... This brazier has long since run dry of oil. Only ashes remain in the bottom. This sarcophagus appears to have been here for centuries. There is no lid. The exterior seems to be made of solid stone. Little tomb. And another brazier. And how are we doing on the fat XPs? Oh, we got a long way to go. Get to level 5. Mortal hit level 4, though. Are there any new assets but the gooey textures, says Anonymous. That is a good question. I like the highlighting on the sprites, too, as I've mentioned. I mean, overall, just the treatment that you've given to this game and the way you've made it more usable and attractive and user-friendly for a modern gamer on a modern computer, fantastic. You know what I want to know, though, Mr. Beamdog or Ms. Beamdog? I can't really speculate. But, what's the deal with announcing it so late? I mean... You're like, hey, by the way, this is a thing. It's coming out in, like, a few days. I mean, that was weird to me. Don't you guys normally, or most companies, don't they normally announce something, like, months ahead of time? Or more? It was kept, like, under wraps or something for the longest time, and then all of a sudden, boom, it's here! Which surprised me quite a bit. I mean, obviously, it's not a problem, but very surprising. Okay. We're about to exit out into the City of Sigil itself. So let's do another quick save. Here we go. Oh, we got a full motion video. Sigil. So Sigil is shaped like a torus. Or like a donut or a bagel if you prefer. As you saw there, that was the city curving up around. This city is shaped, I mean, you can't tell by looking at the map in any way, but it's shaped like, it's basically the city is situated along the inside curve of something that looks like a donut or a bagel or something. So it's a very strange city, to say the least. What is up, Bacons and Eggs K? How you doing? BioWare was hiding new Mass Effect, but this game turned out to be not finished. I guess, but it seems like they announced Andromeda was coming out a long ass time ago. Here we are. Open tomb. We've made it out to the Hive. Well, that was cool. Look at this. Watch this. Whoop! That little zoomy business. We got some Hive thugs. Now, ordinarily, what I do when I play one of these RPGs is I go to the very first zone I come across and I explore it thoroughly and I talk to everybody and I do whatever's in that on that map before going on to someone else. But I'm not going to do that this time. I'm going to mix it up. I'm going to go straight for a certain area in the game to do certain things before I start just randomly exploring the area and talking to everybody. Not sure what you're allowed to talk about. Okay, you promised it was for good reasons? Hey, that's cool. I mean, the game's out now, so it's a moot point anyway, but I was personally shocked when it was announced, and I'm like, okay, so this is going to be coming out, and then I saw when it was coming out, and I was utterly flabbergasted by how soon. And I'm glad it's here. I'm excited. Oh, they showed close to nothing before premiere. I see, but cool. Alright, so we're not gonna explore this area right now. We're not gonna look around. We're not gonna
I'm gone.
Talk to anyone. We're just gonna rush through here. and go to a different part of the hive. Ah, that music. That Mark Morgan soundtrack, though. If I can remember how the fuck to get through here. Also, we're not gonna fight these guys. If they decide they wanna fight us, we're just gonna run. Let's see. Where's the exit? Why do I not remember? No, it's not over there. There it is.
I'm gone.
This is still not the part of the hive that we want to go to. Let's see. This is the part that we want to go to. So we need to get...
I'm gone.
...over there somehow. Don't remember quite how everything's laid out yet. The section of the city that I want to be in. And where is the building? Specific building that I'm going for, I think. Vines on this building have withered from the heat emanating from the walls. Yep, this is it. This is the building. And we're going to go in here.
Trying to put him out, buy him a drink. He's thirsty. He's on fire. He's a red hot. Come on in. Come on in. See what I mean.
And here we are at the Smoldering Corpse Bar. An iconic location. And you'll notice if you watched my Torment Tides of Numenera playthrough, remember when I went to the Fifth Eye and I said, man, this place looks a whole lot like the Smoldering Corpse Bar? It's like such a total obvious visual reference. And now, as you look at this place, you can see what I was talking about. Alright, so we get here, we're going to save the game again. And it is time for me to end this episode. Now... yeah, I think I need to take a little break, actually. So... if you're watching the stream, I will be back shortly. If you're watching on YouTube, this episode is now over. So thank you for watching. This has been Josiah Plays Torment, Planescape Torment, Enhanced Edition.